Yes. Good boy. Good boy. Oh man, it is a cold day here in Southwest Missouri. We got some snow coming down right now. So I got to do the evening chores, which means I got to bring some water out to these guys. Everything's frozen up. Gave them some water and, bringing it out in a jug and filling up some bowls for them. But anyway, that's the way it goes. Could be a lot worse out, I guarantee it. All right, guys, I know you want some water. Get back, everybody. Get back. How you doing on food? You're doing fine. There you go. Everybody come and get some water. Have at it, guys. Okay. I'll get you guys some water, too. Oh. Hey, guys. Welcome back to another Slightly Redneck video. Again, my name's Chris. And if you're not familiar with this channel, I help you to produce your own meat, eggs, and vegetables from your backyard, your balcony, your deck, your garage, even a spare room in your house if that's the way you want to do it. Today I want to talk about feeding mealworms to your quail. I get a lot of questions about this, a lot of discussion about this during the live broadcasts, whether you should feed them to them, whether you shouldn't feed them to them, how old do they need to be before you feed them to them, all kinds of things. So I thought I'd get that addressed in video. It's actually a pretty simple topic to talk about. All right, first of all, mealworms are a great treat for your birds. Don't make it their primary diet, but it's a great supplement to help get your protein up if you have low protein feed, or just as a treat, something to feed them from time to time. They do enjoy them. They like them, just like any other kind of omnivorous bird that's going to eat insects and things. They do like to have those mealworms or any kind of little worm, but I would say you don't want to feed them to your baby quail in the brooder boxes. And the biggest reason for that is that mealworms look an awful lot like quail toes. And your babies, especially the young quail, seem to get very ferocious about eating. And it's like they don't have their wits about them just yet. So you start feeding them mealworms, they start mistaking the other baby's feet for mealworms, and they start going after them trying to eat their toes. Now, they're probably not going to eat their toes, but they could do some damage. They can trample the young birds. They're a little bit fragile at that point. It's not as big of an issue when the birds get older. When the birds get older, they can kind of handle themselves, and it's not that big of a concern that you're going to have to worry about other birds, going after their toes and those kinds of things. That's not a big issue. So I would wait until the birds are probably, 5 weeks old, something like that, before you start feeding them mealworms. If you do need to up your protein level, you can get dried mealworms when they're young. And you can grind those up or crush them up a little bit so they don't look like a mealworm anymore. You don't have to worry about the babies going after each other's feet. Now, if you've ever seen babies in a brooder box, when a fly gets in there or something like that, boy, they just go nuts after that thing. So you might understand why I say that. It's probably not best to feed live mealworms, especially, or whole mealworms for that matter, to your baby quail. You don't want to give them any reason to attack the other birds for, any reason like that. They're a little bit more fragile at that point. Hopefully that kind of makes sense. But as far as mealworms go, again, great supplement for your feed, great treat for your birds. It should not be their primary food source, though. They do need lots of other things that mealworms don't provide in their diet. In the wild, quail eat many things, not just insects. They eat insects, but they also eat seeds and grains and all those kinds of things, too. And they need that good, balanced diet. So that's why I stick with a quail food. A game bird food that provides them all the nutrients that they need. And, I don't rely on trying to feed them with a natural diet that can get a little bit confusing. But that's just the way I do it. You can do it however you want to. But anyway, just a short video to address that today. It's cold out. It's snowing right now. So I'm not going to spend too much time out here jabbering on. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, God bless.